Okay, good afternoon friends, let's begin today. So for communication skills, today we people are going to look maybe if you require any kind of revision, otherwise we are going to begin with the next part of this communication skills. So it is upon you that you people will tell me okay, as far as ISC second is concerned, whether it is required to just again discuss some more examples of dialogue writing, or whether it is required to go through once again from reading comprehension. So with this, I will start my today's class. So all you people have to answer. Majority of students, just give me your feedback that whether there is a need to go to reading comprehension and dialogue writing, because these are two major questions that we people are going to have in our ISC second. So people can unmute and speak, or if you want to send into chat box, that will be fine. So let me know what you people are thinking of. Otherwise, see what I have planned today, where I'm going to start with last unit, that is writing practices. So I'm asking before start, if you have any suggestions or your queries, questions, so that I will just do that. And if you don't have, then it will be fine for me. So I think that you people are not getting me. I'm just asking you people that what should we do? Should we go back and have revision for dialogue writing and reading comprehension? Or if you don't have any need of such a dialogue writing and reading comprehension, then shall we go for unit number 5, where we are going to have writing practices. So in that, we people will discuss that what you people are just going to learn. So answer me, and I'm waiting here for your reply. So you people may say yes, no, or whatever your opinions are. So it is not anybody else. You have to give your whatever it may be, your opinion. Don't think of others, what others will say. We are not going to consider others. So we'll think what majority of students are saying. Accordingly, we'll take decision. It will not be that if one is saying that we'll go back and have revision, so we are going to have revision, or what we people are planning. So whatever majority of students are suggesting, that we are going to follow. Okay, so there is no any response at all, only one response. Based on that, I'm going to take decision, and that response is that we are going to start with last unit number 5. So is there anyone who still thinks different, that he or she wants to just go back and have maybe dialogue, or maybe even from unit 1st also, that some part we have not completed even. So that way people will do afterwards. Maybe that we would like to complete. I think that some of the some of the teachers, they are requiring more lectures, and maybe they are taking extra lectures also. So once we finished our unit number 5, then we can allocate these are lectures, and it can be given to other subjects if we have done them. So I'd like to say that students of Division A, they are not interactive. So whenever I'm asking, you people are not giving your opinion at all. So let it be. So I will decide what to do based on that, what responses I have received. So majority of students, what they are just sending me, they're saying that we should begin with a new topic. So it's better. It will be better. As I told you that many of the teachers, they're conducting extra lectures. So if we could finish within 2 or 3 hours, maybe 4 hours, then we people can assign our lectures to other subjects, and then these teachers will just continue with their subjects, those who are lagging, or they need more maybe lectures also. Today, maths teachers also, Jagdar sir, they are also asking me to give my lecture to them. So, but we are not done with our syllabus. So, rather, we will continue with 3-4 lectures more. And after that, we people will just quit our lectures and give it to others. So in case of dialogue writing, already we people have done with and simple examples that which we people have discussed. Out of that only, you people think of, first of all, your beginning. Your beginning is going to start with greetings, and then you people are going to develop the situation which is given there. Maybe a situation, usually common situation is there, so that we come across in our day-to-day life, that situation will be there. And then you people have to close your dialogues with proper closing, like have a good day, or nice to meet you, or it's my pleasure to talk to you, depending upon situation, whether it is formal situation or informal situation. Based on that, you people have to just think like this. Okay. So I will just begin and I will just start with this new topic, communication skills that we people want to complete. That will be topic number 5, unit number 5, and this is writing practices. Aditya will talk about dialogues maybe afterwards also, because I have to take decision of majority. So majority of students, they are talking about this, that we should go back and start with, we should start with our new unit number 5. So if still have any doubts, questions, we people may discuss it afterwards. So will it okay, Aditya? Just one, the people just let me know if my screen is visible to you. And voice is audible to everybody. So let me know, what do people see on the screen? Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Do you see the unit number 5 writing practices on the screen?
Yes, sir.
Huh.
Okay, fine. Now people pay attention, all of you, that what we people expected to do in this writing practices. Okay, so it is very important that we people use language and the types of communication. If I would like to discuss, there are various types, and out of these various types, here we people will discuss that two only. So which these two? They may be communication can be done in various forms, where we, it can be verbal, communication and non-verbal communication. Okay, so in short, we will talk about what verbal is, what non-verbal is. Okay, and then we'll go back to this. Okay, so first of all, about verbal communication. So what is verbal communication? Verbal is related with words. So, or verbal is related with language that you people have to think of. Okay, so let's think about that, how we people use words or how we people use language. So this verbal communication, again, it gets divided into two parts, as I just told, that we people use words to talk about maybe ideas, emotions, or things which are happening around us, or describing people, describing places, talking, gossiping, lots of things are happening. So we people express these all things with the help of language, with the help of words. So now I'm also talking to you people. So how do I communicating with you? I'm using words, and with that, I'm just expressing what I wanted to tell to you people. Okay, so this way I'm using words, but these words can be used again two forms. So based on this, verbal communication is divided into two types, and this is oral communication. And another one is written communication. Okay, so these are again types of communication which are getting divided into further. So now let's pay attention that about oral communication. In previous we people have talked about, there was one unit, unit number 3 was oral communication. Okay, and I think that I have explained that what is importance of oral communication. Maximum of our time we spend in oral communication. Okay, so in oral communication, you people have to express your thoughts and ideas in the form of spoken words. Okay, so right now I'm communicating with people. Is it oral or written? It is oral, because here I'm not writing. Maybe I'm writing on the screen, but not like whatever I'm speaking. This is oral communication. So in oral communication also, you people have to pay attention that how you can make your oral communication effective. So whenever you people are going to use language, and most of the times you people have to take care that it is not in your mother tongue. You people have to use second language or third language, or sometimes this is called foreign language also. And maybe you are required to learn some foreign languages, like maybe German, French, Japanese, something like this also. So that time it becomes very difficult to convey your thoughts in the same way that you can communicate in your mother tongue. For example, if I ask you people to speak in mother tongue, you people will be very much happy that whatever thoughts and ideas that are coming to your mind, you are simply and easily communicating without any barriers. But if I ask you people that today we will have to speak in English, most of the students will be nervous that they will not be in position to open their mouth, because simply they think, even today also they think, that English is the most difficult language, and you are in position to not use it for day-to-day communication also. Maybe perhaps you people manage to write in the exams, because that study pattern is there, marks are there, or our education system, you people all know, because of that you could manage there in getting marks and passing exams. But if we decide that examination should be conducted orally, so there will be oral interview, examiner will ask you questions and then you people have to answer. So based on this, if your exams will be there, then I think that it will be changed. But these days this is not possible, and in fact that we give very less importance for this oral communication as far as English is concerned. So therefore, what happens that many of the students, they complete their graduation, they get good marks also, 90-95% marks also the people will get. And even today, that because of this COVID pandemic situation, exams are online, and because of that some students, they get unnecessary benefit of this exam system, and they are getting marks also. But it doesn't mean that if they are getting marks, they are going to achieve great miles. No, not at all. So therefore, these people have to use these whatever the skills, knowledge they know. They should be in position to express them. They should be in position to explain them to other people. So in the interview, interviewer is going to ask you procedure. Interviewer is going to ask you coding, decoding, programming, whatever it may be, your softwares, and what technical knowledge you people are going to get of your branch. Is going to ask you questions, and then you people have to answer. And if there you people fail to present yourself or to show what you know, then it will be difficult, and so there you will just lack that whatever you have achieved by unfair means, like copying and just maybe MCQ exams which you people have done not sincerely. So those students will face lots of difficulties there. So oral communication is also part of your life, personal life and professional life. So let's talk about your personal life. As far as English communication is concerned, you people are expected to communicate at your workplace. Suppose that you have started your job with Wipro or something like this, and there you are going to work and you are going to talk with people there. So you have to use oral communication there. Without oral communication, you cannot survive in industry, any of the industry, maybe corporate world, maybe anywhere you go in the world, that you people have to do oral communication there. And medium of communication, it will be always English. So you people have to work for that. Now think of another part, that apart from oral communication, it will not be always oral communication. Maybe maximum time will be spent in oral communication, but sometimes there are some situation in your professional life that you people are expected to write also. So what you're expected to write, you people are expected to do some correspondence that you people have to do with your own company or with other companies also. And that is in the form of written communication. So you are expected to write emails. For example, if you are a manager and you have to give report to your higher authorities, maybe CEO or MD or something, there are higher authorities always, or maybe management is always there. So you people have to convey that what is the work or what is the progress of your department, of your team, that how you people are doing, how you people are performing, whether you are performing up to date, are there any challenges that there you are facing, or if you are not performing up to the mark, then you maybe need to explain that because of what you people are not able to perform up to the mark, what are the reasons that you are lagging behind. And if you are doing nice at that level also, people will be asked, by number of people will ask that what are the reasons that you are doing very nice, tell us your strategies, tell us your experiences. So that time you're expected to share your experiences also, and maybe that can be in written format. So therefore meetings, that you people need to prepare agendas and minutes. Always remember that meetings are in oral communication, but before that you people are expected to prepare its agenda, and after meeting you people have to write down minutes also. So therefore it is part of written communication as well. Already I have told you about emails also, that you people have to communicate all these things to your higher authorities, to your colleagues, notices, etc., in the form of this written communication with the help of emails. Apart from that, there are letter writings. So different kinds of letters are there. You people are expected to write it down. And maybe in 10th standard, you people might have written some letters, like formal letters, informal letters, or something like this. But afterwards, it is going to be part of your professional life. Suppose that you wanted to just order some raw material or some furniture, computers, and lots many things are there. But these days, maybe you are not going to write literal letter, but they can be in the form of mails also, that you people have to write it down. So written communication is also very important part of your professional life. So think yourself, maybe after 5 years, what you'll be doing, you'll be just working with some of the organizations, and there you people are expected to just perform some written communication also. So that was about oral communication, or that I just explained here, verbal communication, which is in two forms, that oral communication and written communication. So now let's talk about this oral communication. If you want to do oral communication, what you people are expected to have. Okay, so therefore you should just work on your tone or your voice. Maybe you people are expected to think of your pronunciation. Okay, so these are the factors that people have to work on. Take care of these things when you people are going to speak. Also, while you have to be polite and humble when you are doing oral communication, in tone, rising tone, falling tone, these things you people have to take care. So in written communication also, people are expected to take care of some certain things. If you are doing written communication, so that time it is expected that you people have to take care of your words that you people are going to use. Apart from that, grammar that you should know. Apart from that, you people have to think of your punctuation mark. And apart from that, you people need to take care of maybe spellings. So these are the points that you people have to consider when you people are going to write something. Okay. With this, we people will talk. In short, I will talk about non-verbal communication now. So if you understand what verbal communication is, then who will tell me what is non-verbal communication? If you know, you just tell me. What is non-verbal communication? reply someone, tell me if you know. So in verbal, I have told, in verbal communication, we people use words of language, and words can be used in two ways, oral and written. So what will be non-verbal communication then? It will be exactly opposite of verbal. So what will it be? I want answer from you people. Is it audible? Let me know first. Is my voice audible clearly to everybody?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. So if verbal communication is the with the help of words, so it will be exactly opposite of this. So what it will be? The communication in which we people are not going to use words at all. This will be non-verbal communication. It is very simple. Okay, so now you people tell me, is it possible to do such communication where you people are not going to use words at all? Is it possible? How can you do non-verbal communication? Any example you, if you like to give me the example of non-verbal communication? Or it is not possible?
Actions.
Yes, exactly. Actions are there. So that will be okay. That maybe, yes, facial expression. Anuja, you're right. Snehal. On TV, we people actually, we get words in the listening form, or maybe we watch them. If you're just watching without word, then TV will be there. So facial expressions are there. Body language is there. Yes, Pranali, you're right. So with the help of these, it is possible that we people can communicate non-verbally also. Okay. Eye contact is there. Yes, Pranali, you're right. That these are the things that we don't pay attention, but are very important, very important. Suppose that right now. Yes, Pranali.
Touch message.
Yes, touch message is also there. That lot of things are conveyed. The things that we cannot convey with words, those things are conveyed with the help of this non-verbal communication. Whenever you people are just meeting to each other, or maybe if you are having face-to-face communication, so that time you people have to work on this. Right now, you people may be having online mode, but it is very difficult to use all those things. Maybe facial expression and eye contact and all those things. Okay, so therefore, when you people are going to become professionals, so that time you people will take care that your eye contact, your facial expressions, your appearance, your hairstyle, and maybe everything, tone of voice is also non-verbal. You're right, Pranali. That everything is very important, that it gives, it adds extra meaning to your words. So whatever you are speaking, maybe with the help of words, you are just conveying only some things only, up to some extent only. But with these your words, if you are going to use those things, that your facial expressions, you are changing, you are having some smile, you are having maybe expression of some feelings like joy and happiness, sorrow, etc. with the help of your face. Maybe you are maintaining eye contact with your speakers and your maybe listeners. So that time you are having a different influence, or you are going to have impact of these things. So non-verbal communication is also one of the ways to talk to people. And apart from this, there are some pictures and signs and symbols also. Suppose that if I show you people that a thumbs up sign, so this thumbs up sign is also conveying some meanings. And maybe if you want to call someone who is away from you, so you are not going to use any voice or words, but simply you are just going to like come here, someone like this. Or maybe sometimes you nod your head. Suppose that when I ask you, do you understand? Simply you can just nod your head and just tell yes, no, or you can move your head up and down, and you just convey some of the these things. Yes, these days, because of this social media, lots of emojis are also, that emojis are also part of non-verbal communication. All you people have to remember about these emojis, that with the help of emojis, you express your laughter, you convey your smile, you convey your grief, you convey your regrets, you convey your lots of things that you convey with the emojis. So emojis are also a part of your non-verbal communication. And artifacts, is also part of non-verbal communication pranali. So what are artifacts? Artifacts are nothing but what are the things which are there, maybe at one particular place. So that is called artifacts. Okay, so in short, I will explain, this is not part of our curriculum, but I just wanted to know you people that how you people have to, I'm telling you people that you have to take care of these things, because you people are going to become professional. All you people imagine yourself that after 3 to 4 years or 5 years, you people will be working with some of the organizations in companies, multinational companies, and there you people have to use these things. So therefore, I'm just realizing you people that you people have to take care. So artifacts is nothing but the things that you people see. For example, if you go to an office of some person, so what you see there usually, you'll see that the color of their office, you'll see that a bookshelf is there. So based on that, there are some books and their list of books is there. So based on these books, you will come to know that what is this person about. Maybe there is some showpiece is there. Maybe some curtains, maybe lights, and so many things are there. So all these things come in artifacts. Okay. In short, that is infrastructure. It's color, light, air ventilation, etc. That will come into artifacts. So artifacts is also part of non-verbal communication that you people have to take care. Okay. So these are different parts, types of communication that in fact I was talking, but right now in today's class, I'm just going to focus on this only, written communication. Okay. So now come back to the point that our name of unit, that is writing practices. This is very important for all of us, that maybe today you're not expected to write, or if you are expected to write, how you're writing, you are just writing with the help of just notes only, or the maybe you're merely copying from one notebook to another notebook, but this does not come in writing practices. Here, this writing practices means strictly this is professional writing, this is formal writing. Okay, so let's see what point we people are going to cover in this unit number 5. So 5.1, it is going to be writing business letters. So all you people will just think of this, that different kinds of letters you people are going to write it down, maybe professional letters, business letters. Usually it consists of inquiry letter, order letter, complaint letter, then job application letter, and writing your CV or resume. These things will come here. We'll not talk about this Bloom's level here. What you are expected to do, that will be Bloom's level. So don't go for Bloom's level right now. So you people are going to write down different business letters. Next one is 5.2. Here we people are going to talk about email communication. So this is the era, modern age, modern world, where everything is driven by this email. Maybe whatever communication here takes place, it is in the form of emails. And in olden times, you people will come to know that there were letters, and with the help of post, you people were writing letters and sending letters and receiving letters. So that was olden time, which was taking a lot of time. It was time consuming. But because of this revolution, modern revolution in the form of computers and internet, it is possible that today we are writing such mails. So email means electronic mail. So within short span, once you just send, hit the send button, within second of fraction of second, this mail is seen in the receiver's inbox. So therefore, this is the fastest generation. Here a lot of time and maybe money and energy is saved because of this electronic mail. So here we people should learn how to write effective emails, and what are the points which are there in that email. So that we people will be discussing. And last one, that will be paragraph writing and essay writing, which is important part of, again, writing skills, where you people are expected to write down your thoughts and ideas on the given topic. So that all things we people will be discussing. Okay, so with this introduction, we people will just begin with this 5.1, writing business letters. So let's try to understand what is this concept about. So business is the exchange of products and services on the basis of money. सो दिस इज वॉट यू पीपल आर गोइंग टू डू. जॉब करायचा म्हणजे काय करणार आहात तुम्ही लोक, तर यू आर गोइंग टू जॉईन सम ऑर्गनायझेशन. ऑर्गनायझेशन म्हणजे कशी असणार आहे ती ऑर्गनायझेशन, तर युजली देर इज सम काइंड ऑफ प्रोडक्शन किंवा सर्व्हिस असणार. फॉर एक्झाम्पल एखादी कंपनी काहीतरी प्रोड्यूस करत असते, मे बी तुमच्या हातामध्ये असणारा पेन असेल किंवा मोबाईल आहे. सो वॉट इज दिस, दिस इज अ काइंड ऑफ प्रोडक्शन. किंवा तुम्ही इंटरनेट यूज करता, वॉट इज इंटरनेट, इंटरनेट इज अ सर्व्हिस. ओके, सो दिस इज बेस्ड ऑन मनी. So this is called business. So you people are going to produce mobiles, you are going to provide some services like banking or maybe internet, maybe lots of services are there. So all these having base of money. In business there are two parties, that is supplier, or it is called producer or provider, and customer or consumer. Okay, so these two parties having some business or transactions or deals, we can call the दोघांमध्ये अशा प्रकारचे business transactions that usually this part of their day to day activity, it is part of their business. म्हणजे काहीतरी गुड, suppose that you are producing mobiles, तर mobile produce करून तुम्ही काय स्वतःसाठीच वापरणार आहे का? No, you are going to supply it for other people, and out of that you are going to earn some profit and you are going to earn some money. Okay, so you are just a producer. And then who will be customer? So customer will be the person who is going to buy your mobile, and in return that they are going to pay you some money. So customer and consumer, there is difference, a short difference. Customer is the person who is using products, that is called customer, and consumer is the person who is using services, so that is called consumer. Again, similar word is client also sometimes, but let it be, you don't get in more details about these things. Okay, then petition that these two parties write letters to one another with specific purposes. So I just told you that there are two parties, one is supplier, one is receiver, one is producer, another is customer, provider and consumer can be, and there is some give and take. Business is what? Give and take. They are giving something, they are taking something. Okay, and because of these there are some reasons, specific purposes that these people they have to fulfill, they have to complete, and for that these people they write letters to one another. Okay, so here we people are going to talk about letter writings. The exchange of those letters is known as business correspondence. So what is business correspondence? If you are sending letter to other organization and other organization is replying to your letter, that will be simply business correspondence. So what is business? Business is exchange of products and services on the basis of money. What is business correspondence? For this business you need some give and take. For that you people write down letters to each others, and that is called business correspondence. So it includes different types of letters. Okay, so this is just for our information. Now pay attention, what kind of letters can be drafted. Okay, so here four types of letters are usually given here. First letter is enquiry letter. So its name itself suggests that what is enquiry letter. So what is enquiry? Usually when you inquire, you just try to get more information. Simply enquiry means getting information. Suppose that you would like to buy some computers, you would like to buy some maybe furniture, you would like to buy some mobiles or whatever required for your company that you are going to purchase. In that case, if you are going to just take more information, that will be inquiry letter. Okay, so inquire about its product, its maybe durability, its quality, its price, and so many things that if you are just inquiring, that will be just inquiry letter. Then second is quotation letter. So what is quotation? Have you heard about this word quotation? म्हणजे एखादी बघा बाईक वगैरे घ्यायची किंवा काहीतरी मोठं वस्तू वगैरे घ्यायची असेल तर अगोदर कोटेशन काढतात लोक. सो कोटेशन काढतात म्हणजे काय? तर हाऊ मच एक्झॅक्ट मनी यू आर सपोज टू पे अँड फॉर वॉट. किती पैसे द्यावे लागतील आणि कशासाठी द्यावे लागतील आणि त्यामध्ये कोणकोणत्या गोष्टी इन्वॉल्व होतात. सपोज दॅट यू वॉन्ट टू बाय अ फ्रीज, यू वॉन्ट टू बाय अ बाईक ऑर मे बी फोर व्हीलर. सो if you are going to buy a four wheeler, you are taking quotation, you are asking for quotation. So quotation will include that price of a four wheeler is like this, and initially you people have to pay like this, and afterwards you can have this kind of features, and then you people are going to pay remaining fee in this ways. So this is quotation letter. Exactly how much amount you are supposed to pay, expected to pay, that will be quotation letter. And then once you get the quotation, then based on this your preferences, you people are going to order this. If you like these computers and if price is in your reach, then you people are going to order those computer or maybe two wheeler or four wheeler, whatever the thing that you are going to ask, or raw material also. We are talking in terms of business. So suppose that some raw material like furniture, rubber or whatever it may be required, so you are going to order these things to your company. And then next part of this process comes, that is complaint. Suppose that you ordered computers and there are 10 computers that you have ordered, but somehow you received it 9. So what is that? One computer is missing. So you're not going to accept this. You're going to ask for compensation. So you're going to write down complaint later. Or maybe that you received 10 computers also, but out of these 10 computers, 9 are working very fine, but out of that one is not starting. Okay, so that is defective, having some fault, maybe damaged, or whatever problem is there. Simply problem is there. So in that case, what you are going to do, you are going to write down complaint letters also. Okay. So there is a logical chain of these letters in business. Logical chain. First of all, you are going to inquire. Then you are going to ask for quotation. Then you are going to order it. And if you did not receive your order as per your requirement, as per your demand, then you are going to have complaint. So this is, there is logical chain of these letters. All of the above letters are drafted on the letterheads of the concern organization company. So therefore you should know what letterhead is. So I hope that perhaps you might have seen what letterhead is usually. So letterhead is nothing but this is printed format of company, a particular company. Suppose that there is XYZ company. So this company, they will have their printed on the top of on the top margin, they will have name of the organization, address, their contact details, and all every information which is required, that will be there already printed on one page, that is called letterhead. And then these people use these pages for writing down letters. In earlier time, upon letter lihtana kay karayacho baka, tar from pan lihayacho. From manje kay ki jo koni patra lihnar ahe to from asayacha. Tar ita apan from manje kay asnar ita letterhead asnar. From manje company, kutli company, to company kuta ahe, and all those things will be mentioned here. That will be on letterhead. So here one format or layout people will say, this is given, how to write a business letter. Kasa lihayacha, mag kay asnar, suruvat kashi asnar ahe. Tar already the letterhead I just told. So sender's address, there is no need to mention on your letter. Jo tumhi letterhead jar vaprat asal tar tya letterhead varti sender's address lihayachi garaj asnar nahiye. No need to write it down. You can skip this. Ka lihayachi garaj nahi, karan tumcha letterhead varti sender's address ha printed format madhe already dito asto. So therefore you don't write it. Then next point, number second, you people will come to know, that will be their date. Okay, and date, and here nowadays you people have to also remember that there is outward number also. Outward number is what, that ki kutlya prakarcha document ahe, honara communication jar future reference sathi asta baka, jar hecha mala future madhe reference lagat vagere asel tar ta outward numbers astat. Ta outward numbers, ta based on year, file, department, yachyanusar ti outward number asa kai tari specific tayar hot astat. Maybe for example, if you are going to think of any outward number, so like this, so Swery slash then 2019 or 21 is the year, then maybe department like this, maybe CSE, okay, and then its outward number maybe depending upon this is 22 or 23rd number of this kind of letter. So something like this outward number is there usually. And then at the same line towards the right hand side, there is a date. It is mentioned like this. Okay, so this is format. Actually, if you are having on piece of paper, I could give it more details. So while writing date, you people have to take care that these days date is written in various formats also. That you will come to know that there are two ways writing date. One is American, another is British also. So maybe you will find that while writing date, you will come to know usually what will people follow. That if it, today's date, I would like to write down today's date. So maybe today is 12th and it is of fourth month of the year 2021. That is what we commonly follow. But apart from that, you will come to know that there is another format also. Usually you will find it that computer format uses like this. Instead of writing down date, this is DDMMYY format. So DDMMYY, date, month, and year. But you will come to know that computer uses this format. It is usually, first of all, month. So they are going to mention month in the beginning. Then they are going to mention date. And then there will be year of. Okay, so this is also format which is used. And apart from that, you people will also come to know that instead of mentioning a month in numbers, sometimes month is mentioned in words also, like this. If today is 12th and then if it is April, so it will be mentioned like this, then comma and then year 2021, something like this. So you just follow one format only. It is not necessary that someone is standard and another is not. It will be okay. But mostly in India, if you think that people don't use this format, not at all. And if you use this format, you will confuse everybody. You yourself will be confused and others will be also confused better. So mostly use the format will be this one. And if you want to change it, if you were to use another one, this will be. And here also that separated with slash, sometimes you'll find that there is a dash also. And sometimes you'll find that some people use dot also, but don't use dot, okay? Dot is not a proper way in date to use. So don't use dot, rather than it will be better to use slash only, okay? This care, you people take care about date, okay? Then let's go to the next. Is it audible? Aikta yete ka sir? Aikta na sagle jan?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
All right. So maybe that I'm just going. I thought that it may be one way communication only. So I just wanted to confirm. Let it be. Now pay attention, all of you people. Come to the point, and we people will talk about now third point, that is inside address. So what is inside address? So inside address is nothing but usually address to whom we people are going to write the letter. Okay. So for example, if it is in professional or business letters, usually letters are written to a specific person. So you people have to mention his designation. Maybe for example, if you are going to write down letter like that, it will be two. Okay. So after two, you people have to give comma, then you people have to skip this line, and then you people have to come down. Then you people have to mention to whom you are going to write. If you are going to write down a specific person that you know, in that case, you people can mention his name, maybe Mr. A.B. Sharma or something like this, what your Patil, what your Pawar, something like this. But if you don't know the name of that person, in that case, if you know the designation, that you people have to use designation. For example, the manager. So here you are going to use designation. Okay, that you people have to take care. Then you people have to mention the name of this organization to whom you are going to write down the address. For example, if you are going to write down this letter to maybe some XYZ company. Take just an example, XYZ company, organization, something like this. And below that, there will be address of this company. Maybe you can mention in short, not necessary, you people have to give detail address. And then maybe PIN code like 0604. Or if you know, you're going to mention it in full. Okay, maybe a 6-digit PIN code also you can mention. So this is called inside address to whom you are going to write down later. Okay, so it will consist to whom you're going to write down. If you know his name particularly, you mention it. If you don't know, you have to mention his designation, then name of that company, address of that company, etc. You people have to write it down. Then next, we people will talk about this attention line, point number four. So let's try to understand what this attention line. Attention line is nothing but it is subject. Okay, so simply we people will just think it subject. So what is subject and why should we write it? So subject is nothing but which catches your attention first. When you receive any letter or any email also, so that is nothing but people don't immediately read all those letters or mails, but we just first read subject of this particular mail or letter. And depending upon then we decide whether it is important. It is depending upon your priority preferences will decide important, non-important, or whether you want to just include it into spam. So subject will just give you idea about what you people are going to write this letter. So if it is inquiry letter, you people are going to mention that how people are going to inquire about something that you need. So you just start your subject like this, inquiry about furniture, computers, or whatever you would like to just buy like this. So it is called attention line. But is usually you people have to mention it in short. It should not be lengthy. It should not be more than one line. Maximum two lines are sufficient, but don't make your subject too lengthy. Okay, so that is your attention line. Then next point, that is salutation. Okay, so now people talk about salutation. So what is salutation? Salutation is nothing but in Marathi you can call it abhivadan. So when you we people write letters, so people have to salute people based on their the designation and everything, that we people have to salute. So how we people will use salutations? What salutation you people will use? What salutation we will use? Here it will be always. You might have heard about that. Respected sir. If you know that you are writing letter to male colleague, male employee, that will be respected sir. If you know that if it is female, then you are going to add madam. And if you don't know whether it is sir or madam, in that case you are going to use slash sir, madam. Okay. Or if you are going to refer to both of them, in that case also you are going to use like this. So this is used maybe in formal situations. So sometimes today you will find that dear is also used. So is it okay to say dear sir? Dear madam? So these days you will find that dear sir is also used in formal. Perhaps you might have thought that respected is used in formal and dear is used in informal, but this is not any kind of maybe difference that you people have to follow. You people can use dear sir and dear madam also. Maybe formally that you people know to each other, in that case you people can use. But if you're going to write first time and to a stranger, in that case use respected. Okay, and sometimes you'll find that these days instead of just using respected or dear, only sir is used. That is also possible. Or sometimes you'll find that like this, madam, only madam is also used. Okay, so you people just take note of this and kindly follow this. Okay, and then next we people will talk about body of letter. So here our next point, that is body of letter. So after just beginning with salutation, you people are going to start writing the main content, main body of your letter. So you are going to begin your first paragraph, which will be about this subject. So what you have mentioned in this subject, the same you people are going to refer in your first paragraph of this point, that is body of the letter. Okay, then in next paragraph, you are going to develop exactly what you want to tell, if it is inquiry, if it is order, if it is complaint, that you are going to mention in detail about this, and then you people are going to close it. So usually there are three paragraphs, two or three paragraphs will be there. First will be just beginning, which will be just talking more about this, what, why you are going to write this letter based on your subject line. Then you are going to develop it. There will be middle paragraph, and last will be expecting some action, whether if you are asking for inquiry, you are getting more details. If it is order, you are going to confirm your order. If it is quotation, if it is complaint, you are going to ask for compensation, etc. So that will be body of the letter. You people have to develop this letter into 2-3 paragraphs. Okay, then next point, I will make it clear whatever I have just shown on the screen. Next point we people will think of, this that will be point number 7, which is complimentary clause. Okay, so what is complimentary clause? So people will talk about now, complimentary clause is the thing that where you people would like to just close your letter with the letters like this, yours faithfully. Okay, don't give apostrophe, it is yours faithfully. You'll come to know yours sincerely. You'll come to know yours truly, or sometimes you'll find that maybe different words also. So these words are called complimentary clause, and below that you are going to mention that who are you. Maybe if I'm going to write down later, So I will mention like this, Api Nagni, and then what I am, assistant manager, assistant, whatever it may be, or manager or CEO, something like what my designation is there. I will just mention here the production manager, sales manager, something like this. Okay. And you have to keep some space between this, yours respectfully, and here, that whatever it is. And then next point, you people have to add that signature you people are going to add in between your respectful, that is complimentary clothes, and this. Okay, this is signature that you people have to add here. And last point is this enclosures. Okay, so when we talk about enclosures, what are enclosures usually? So enclosures are nothing but the files that we attach with this letters, okay, or simply attachments, I will say. So you need to attach some earlier previous reference document, or maybe if you have just received any kind of additional, maybe a quotation, maybe some price or whatever it may be, depending upon this, what attachment you are going to attach with this letter, that will come into enclosures. So in enclosures, you people are going to mention that what you have attached, xerox copy of this, maybe 1, 2, 3, you are going to attach files. If there it is, if not, in that case it will be okay. Okay, so this is common format that we people have to just use for writing any of the letters. Okay, so I hope that what all we people have discussed, that people will just go through it. Now this is time that we people have to close it, stop it. So I will just confirm option numbers, and in next class we people will see some of the examples of letter writing, and then people will go for paragraph writing. So again, you people will get the same what we people have discussed, that is again given in details here. So all you people go through these given points, and then we people will see one later. Next class, three different letters we people will talk, discuss, and then we people will, so hardly 2 or 3 lectures we will take more for completion of everything in communication skills. All right, so let me know, students, of these specific numbers are present or absent. Roll number 29 is not there. 31 is there. Let me know, roll number 31, are you there? Okay, then 34 is absent. Then roll number 64. Absent, and 65 is also absent. Okay, so shall we stop here now today? Do you have any questions, kaik shanka, suggestions ahet ka? Okay, so if no, then I'm going to end this meeting for everyone. So thank you for joining today. We people will meet in next class.